You see, little Coonsie, you just met there, is missing tonight in Oklahoma. George says she ran off 9 days ago while he was working on the lines here, and he brought his other little friend with him to help search for Coonsie. Now, let me show you. This is not Coonsie you see right there. That's George's other raccoon. And a 20-person search party fanned out in Norman, where Coonsie was last seen. George says he was busy cutting down trees when she scurried off. He says it's not unusual for Coonsie to go rogue, but this is the longest she's ever been gone, hence tonight's search party. And believe it or not, the majority of those who showed up to help tonight were complete strangers.
I'm just overwhelmed. I've been all over the United States and never seen the hospitality like I got here. Never in my life. She goes everywhere with me. Everywhere. When I open the door to go out of the house, she's right here at my heels. I open the door, she gets in the truck. She goes everywhere with me.
George says he's staying in the Sooner State until he finds Coonsie. The group meets each night to search. While others come and go, George is usually out there until midnight. There are a few ways you may be able to distinguish her from a regular raccoon. For one, George says she's 3 pounds shy of a world record for weight. She's also more grayish in color, and she just might walk right up next to you on the sidewalk since she loves people so much.
That would be 3 pounds shy of a world record.
Well, he brought his other raccoon to help
him search. If the story wasn't enough, we have that.
Wow.
Maybe put some dog food out in a trail camera.
But didn't you say it was microchipped?
It is microchipped. Yeah. So that might be able to help them, but it's microchipped
as long as he stays out of traffic
in Idaho. So we'll see what happens.
I'm going to go back and watch that again.